Hey everybody, and welcome to Let's Look at Reamed Capsule. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. I should just levy that as kind of like carte blanche. I hope I'm pronouncing everything I say in this video correctly, of course. But this is a brand new port, at least. It was originally a mobile game, but don't necessarily hold that against it right off the bat. And it's a Zen-based, minimalistic strategy game that will very much, I think, take you by surprise over the course of this video. It's very slow-moving, but it also, you know, like a Transformer, there's more than meets the eye. It was made by a fellow by the name of Martin Jonasson, who's based in Sweden, and I believe that his alias is Grapefruit, but because it's Swedish, I don't know, it could be like Grappafukte. I don't want to say that it's Grapefucked, because that sounds a little bit offensive, and I don't mean it like that. I'm going to start a new game of Reamed Capsule. I've played about an hour of this so far. It is a puzzle slash strategy game, but it's a long one. This is not like a match 3 game where, you know, a session with it is gonna last anywhere from like 90 seconds to 5 minutes. This is much more like one session lasts as much as an hour, and that's what I've played so far. The time that it says here, 34-32, is the time that I've spent on just this one part of the game. There was a previous one that I did earlier as well. So we're gonna start a new game. We're gonna play it on the normal mode, and we're gonna overwrite our previous game. I would like the opportunity to have multiple save files, but it's probably the type of thing that only really matters for the course of this video, because otherwise you're probably just gonna wanna keep one game on the go. So, the way that this works, the way that Reamed Capsule works, is that it's very minimalistic in its graphic design, but it also looks gorgeous, and you'll see that as we get started here. The game kinda gives you some direction at the top to tell you what to do, and this is nice to keep you kinda focused, but basically, you are going to build a space station, and as I zoom out here, there's a few elements that are important to note. The yellow pyramids are our food, the pink squares are our, I think they're called, the blue cubes are called energy, and I don't actually know what these are called, but they're another valuable resource that is important. And the two little white rectangles that are bouncing up and down are the units that we are going to be using to basically accomplish everything that we want to do in this game, extracting resources from these like pink areas over here and building a space station that will protect us against the AI that is eventually going to come to kill us. So what we do is we use tetradominoes, and you can see which ones are coming soon, to build corridors, and corridor networks basically allow our units to move around and also access these other rooms of the station. So we can click and then assign units just at the bottom here from idle to construction, and they will get started working on this. So basically what they're going to be doing is, as soon as you tell them to construct, you don't have direct control, but they will go and take some of our emergency rations and they'll start building here, because we really need to get a reactor and an extractor up so we can, you know, create some energy and also extract some minerals, basically. So what we'll start with is a reactor, and I just want to put this in such an area that it won't completely screw over my corridor network. I think that's a pretty good place to build a reactor. You can see the cost of it. It costs 6 energy, 2 minerals. Oh, materials is what it's called. Okay, the more you know. And I'm just going to build a little bit out into this corridor network here. Again, you got to think about, you got to plan for the future, but as of right now, what I'm saying probably doesn't really make that much sense. Let's put our extractor, I mean, it's not a bad spot for it. Okay, so what's neat and what's going to kind of infuriate some people, but other people I'm sure will be into it, I actually am into it, is that you don't have direct control over your units. Your units just kind of, there's a task list and they decide what to do independently, and it's not always, at least as it seems, it's not always based on what you would want them to do. So you kind of have to set the conditions such that there's only really one or two things that they are doing, and those are the things that you prioritize the most. So right now I want to put a corridor down to kind of expand out a little bit more, but I want to make sure that they're focusing on building this extractor first so that we can get resources going. So this is a very slow moving game. It'll probably take us about 15 minutes maybe until we reach even self-sufficiency, because these minerals right here, or so I should say these materials right here, are basically the ones that we were given to start with, and we need to eventually become self-sustaining. And the way that this is going to happen is that eventually this blue meter is going to tick up here, and you can see now that we get one more energy cube, and as this meter ticks up, we'll get one more material over here as well. Now we need to make food, so I'm actually going to probably make like a quick extension to my corridor network here, so they'll get working on that, and then I'm going to make a garden, and the garden basically allows me to grow sludge, and then I'm gonna make a kitchen, and the kitchen allows me to convert that sludge to food, which will be necessary when it comes to actually, I'm just trying to think about, maybe that's the best way to do that. That will be necessary to feed units, to build more rooms, and to eventually generate more units, because what you're looking for here is to eventually build like a very efficient space station. Now, there are other things that we can have our units doing as well, not just construction or idle. We could have one of them go on to engineering, and if one of them goes to engineering, then he'll come into a room with a reactor like this. He'll walk back and forth, that meter will come up faster, and we'll get more energy developed more quickly. This is, and I need to throw this out here basically as soon as I possibly can, this is one of those games that I don't think in a video like this 100% comes across easily. And the reason I say that is because the longer you play, the more engaging it gets. And to some extent, you're going to have to take my word for that, or you're going to have to keep watching. Because right now, you might be saying, this looks kind of boring. This looks like nothing's happening. And to some extent, I resonate with that complaint. But as things get going, more and more stuff starts happening, and it really does become kind of a juggling match. I mean, usually there's not competitive matches for juggling, but in my world, in the circles I run in, there are. I do wish that maybe there was like a speed up button so I could make units go faster and stuff like that. When there's very few of them and there's not very much going on like there is right now. But so be it. This is the way the game is. And, you know, again, every session of this takes about an hour. So it's like playing a 4X game like Civilization or something like that, just in a more minimalist context. Or a more minimalist aesthetic, I guess I should say. And the longer the time goes on, the more stuff you have to do. So now I can move one of my units from construction to food service. And what he will do is move sludge into the kitchen. And that will then become food, which again, we can use as a very valuable resource. Now, I'm going to send my other unit to build a weapons building. And what is important about a weapons building is that we will be attacked eventually. The weapons building allows us to have basically like rocket launchers or laser guns that we can shoot at the attackers. This is what's going to create the wave-based gameplay of what happens in this game. I haven't really mentioned it yet, but this meter is constantly going to be going up. It probably takes about, I don't know, 2 to 3 minutes for it to refill every time. And whenever it refills, enemies come. The enemies, they shoot you. If they shoot the units 4 times, the units die. If you lose all your units, you're done. And of course, the more units you lose, the more efficiency you lose. So you really want to keep your units alive as much as possible, which might seem like a no-brainer, but I mean, obviously. So we have a weapons room done, which is good. I'm being very inefficient right now, but let's move one person to food service, and we'll start building towards this other extractor over here. Because you can only extract from these mineral patches that are over here. Now, you might be wondering what's going on with these like monoliths over here. We'll talk about that when we get there, and that shouldn't take too long. But I'm excited that the enemies are about to come so that you can actually see what goes on with the combat, because this is where things become much more difficult and it becomes much more of a juggling of resources. What I really appreciate about this game, and it really becomes apparent the more and more you play, is that in a lot of strategy games, I'm thinking specifically of like, think of something like Crusader Kings, okay? If you look at the Holy Warfare series that Arumba and Mathis and I are running right now, when it comes to building things, we always build the same things. We're like, okay, this gives us more money, so we need to build that as soon as possible. This gives us more, this is another unit that can actually attack other units. We need to build that quickly. In Rimmed Capsule, it's every building is of critical importance. You'll always be tight for resources on something, and every building you build actually takes a while, or every room you build takes a while. And it kind of pulls resources away that make you want to build other buildings. If you build something like quarters, for example, we haven't talked about this yet, but what this basically allows you to do, okay, we should send our units over to defense and you'll see how that works. Quarters allow you to spawn 2 more units, which is extremely important because obviously right now our main limiting reagent for getting things done is not necessarily our amount of resources, it's our amount of manpower that can actually make that work. However, in order to build quarters, it takes forever. Oh, I'll just narrate the combat here for a second. So these are just some scouts that are coming in here. Basically, angry enemies are going to show up all the time. These ones don't actually have any weapons, but it at least shows you how the combat works. So let's move these guys back to construction for now. When you build quarters, it requires 4 energy, 6 materials, and 4 food. That's a fucking ton, basically. As you can see, I mean, we still have some of our resources, or emergency reactions, or rations, sorry, that we started with here. But it's going to take us a while to get 6 food once these are gone, because we have, you can only hold 4 in one kitchen, and moving sludge into the kitchen and then processing it takes time. So, you know, as soon as you start building quarters, you're like, oh man, I'm not getting enough food, I need to build another garden. So you build that garden, and then you're like, well, I need to build another kitchen, there's no point in having 2 gardens and 1 kitchen. And basically, just, you grow and you feed off of your own station, and I kind of begrudgingly admit that video content is not necessarily the easiest way to understand what actually makes this game interesting, except to say that it looks and sounds beautiful, both visually and from a soundtrack perspective. It is a gorgeous game, and hopefully you understand that for yourself. If you're looking at this and thinking, oh, these graphics are too simplistic, I think you're really missing out. Once you get a sprawling space station, it looks really, really good. This is not a game that's for everybody, though. Again, we are about, 9 minutes in here, and I'm still very much... This is like the third time I've done this level, and apparently once you beat this level, there are multiple levels that you can get to, each one approximately being about an hour long. And you can read Steam reviews on the store page if you want to see that information. That's where I gleaned it from. And when you do the same level over and over, you know the first 10 or 15 minutes might be exactly the same. That's not to say it's valueless, because you're going to try to do it in a more efficient way, even though I've already done it in a super inefficient way, because I've blocked myself off from that mineral patch. It can be a little repetitive when you're doing things over and over again. And I will say that, and I say this whenever I cover, like, say, a tower defense game, which this is obviously not, but, the same complaint, I think, does hold some value, especially depending on the kind of person you are. I do wish there was almost just, like, a fast-forward button that I could hold down. Unless this is it and I missed out. It's not. It's the pause button. Let's resume here. So we are about halfway to getting the second wave. We built a quarter, so now what we should do is move someone over to food service, and we'll put somebody else on. I should probably construct something else, but I'm trying to think of what I would construct. Maybe we'll just build corridors, and maybe we'll get to work on a second reactor or something like that. I don't know what I was going to say there. I thought I had something really pertinent to bring up, but I actually didn't. But pretty soon we're going to have some more enemies arising, and food service will allow... not only does it bring sludge to the kitchen, but it also brings food to the quarters, which will then, as this meter ticks up, allow us to get one more unit. So this is basically how you build units. It is much more of a strategy game than a puzzle game, despite the way it initially looks. I'm going to put you on construction as well. So now that we have another unit, you might be thinking, that's awesome, right? Like, we want to use our... Oh man, okay, I need to build more construction. Let's build out to this monolith over here. Now that I have two more units, you might be thinking, oh awesome, our work here is done, we've accomplished what we wanted to do, we have more units. But actually, in order to now get maximum value out of our defense, we have to have another defense building, because each defense building only has two weapons. So I'll probably start building like another defense building right here, as long as I don't block myself off from anything. And the reason you want to do this is because a lot of the units that actually show up will prioritize attacking your targets that don't actually have weapons. So they'll seek out your targets and are your workers. And if your workers don't have weapons, then they're like sitting ducks basically. And once you move over to the defense building, you're stuck in there. Like if I go to build a weapons building over here, you can see this is the range with which they can see. I should move some people over to defense quickly. That's the range with which that building can see. So they're not going to be able to see and shoot at units that come from this side of the map, for example. So these units that are constructing over here will kind of be sitting ducks. I can move them over to idle and maybe have a chance to keep them alive, but hopefully this is giving you a minor example of how the game becomes more frantic and frenetic as it goes on. So the enemies are coming from... There's only one enemy. He's coming from over here, and he's going to hone in on this one, and he's probably going to murder that guy. And that's going to set us really behind the eight ball. In fact, he might murder both of these guys, but at least they can drop off their resources. Oh, thankfully he kind of peeled off, so we were able to destroy him before our units died. And I believe that he has to get them in like pretty quick succession, otherwise there's... no capability. I'm going to move someone to engineering just so we generate more energy over here. No, you should move to engineering and you should move to construction. Why? That's more along the lines of what I'm looking for. There we go. Yeah, so hopefully you've got a little bit more of an idea of why this is maybe... I don't want to... Because what I don't want to say is like that's why it's more engaging than it looks. But that's kind of what I am saying, because again, I think this is kind of a weird thing to bring up. And cover from a video standpoint, but I actually have really enjoyed the time that I've spent with this game so far. I'm just not sure if it 100% translates. It's kind of like a minimalistic, Zen-based base-building game. And for people that are really intimidated by, you know, I know even, like, I play Crusader Kings 2 and EU4 now. I'm not very good at either of them, but, when I played those games originally, I was so intimidated. I was like, oh my god, there's so much depth and complexity, and how do I get into this? There's maybe a little bit less depth and complexity here, but it also has a positive in the form of its accessibility. Like, it's usually fairly easy to do what needs to be done. Why am I missing one weapon over here in my weapons room? That kind of scares me, but that's okay, perhaps. We should probably start building another quarters, actually, so that we can get some more units up as quickly as possible. But it's very easy. Any decision you make can be a right decision, or you can at least make it work. And the enemies do get harder, and more of them show up, but it's way easier to kind of at least, because of this wave-based like mentality, or the wave-based gameplay, it's impossible not to progress. And you're gonna get a little bit better every single time. I haven't found it exceptionally difficult. The time I restarted was because I thought I could build my base in a more efficient way, and I ended up being right about that. I have run out of food, so people need to go on food service. That's probably something I should have done earlier. Again, the major complaint I can levy about this is that it's slow. And that's not necessarily an objective complaint, but it is the kind of thing where, like, what I wanted to do was... I had played for that 34-minute video before I started a new game, or 34-minute off-camera play before I started a new game, and I was gonna, like... If there were multiple save files, I could have been like, okay, so here's how Rimmed Capsule starts, and here's how it looks after 40 minutes when I have, you know, 10 units and 5 defense buildings, and I'm researching these things. Because that's what we can do now. Now we have actually a research panel, as you can see. I won't go to it yet. I'll wait until we get some more units and actually some defensive buildings maybe over here as well, which is probably something we should get to work on. And the reason I won't do that is because these units will be sitting ducks. But basically, these are monoliths, and we can send up to 3 units to research them. You should be on construction. And as they research them, it will give us basically unlocks. So I researched the monolith in the top left when I played off camera, and then by the time I finished it, and it did take a while, it was like, your units are faster. So not only as time goes on are you generating more units, but those units are becoming more efficient. You're getting more resources. You probably have multiple reactors and extractors. By the way, as you can see, the extractors, you know, they pull from the mineral deposits, or material deposits, but the material deposits run out. They only have a finite number, and we're kind of getting low on each of those. So now we're like, oh shit, well, we want to expand up here and get these materials. But the materials that are up here, yes, there we go. The materials that are up here are obviously going to be very far away for me to actually construct something with them. So I've got to get this done as soon as possible, but also I need to defend myself. I can't tell if that's a great corridor network or a terrible one. Come on, extractor, work with me here. There we go. Okay, so now we gotta get as many people to defense as possible, as quickly as possible. So I don't really care what you're doing right now. Drop off the things that you don't need. And now we have, as you can see, 2 defense buildings here, or weapons buildings. And this will allow us to hopefully have a better chance against these enemies. One of those weapons just showed up. It was just a weird little bug that allowed us not to see where the weapon, or where the weapon was there. So there's still only 2 enemies here. But that's a doubling from what we had last time. And now that we have 2 weapons buildings, it's much easier for us to deal with those. It's really, it's a strange game, and I know I've said this many times, but it's a strange game to try to explain, because it really does work well. And once I found myself playing it, it was not like, with a lot of games for Let's Look At, it's games that I'm like middling on. I'm like looking at my watch and I'm like, okay, when will I hit 1 hour, 1 hour and 15 minutes, 1 hour and a half? So I can be like, I did my due diligence on this game, and here's why I'm sort of mixed on it. With this, it's like basically exactly the opposite. I was like, oh, I don't want to stop playing it yet because I want to see what happens, but I should stop playing it because it's like 1 in the morning and I should get some sleep so I could actually record a video tomorrow. Let's send a couple of units. Once these units finish being created in the quarters here, I will have them start researching, so you can see how that works. And that's the slowest. It's like the way you progress through your tech tree, but the tech tree is set out for you. So I really do like this game. I should mention it's coming out. It's going to be $8, I believe, and with a 10% opening week sale. And that's, you know, it's a sore spot for some people because it is a mobile port. I have no idea what it costs on Android. There is going to be a SKU on Steam that will come with the Android version as well as the soundtrack. And the soundtrack has a really nice Boards of Canada vibe to it. I know I've mentioned this before, but sincerely, the soundtrack is really, really good, I think. We should probably try to build another garden and another kitchen as soon as possible. You can see the researching going on here. And I can't stress enough, I really like the way the game looks from like a visual standpoint. I mean, that's kind of redundant, I guess, to say, but it looks minimalistic, but it's also got a really, really nice vibe to it. Even though, you know, when you zoom out, it looks a little bit flat, but when you zoom in, there's actually... All the detail feels meaningful, let's put it that way. I don't need so many units on food service anymore. I probably don't even need units on engineering anymore, so why don't we just move you guys up here, and we'll have more people research. Also, I really like the way it visually indicates how close you are to being done the research. We're only like 10% of the way to being done, because it takes the longest time out of anything. So we have 3 weapons rooms and 6 units. That math adds up. We're about to have another garden. And we should put the kitchen, presumably, pretty close to the garden and pretty close to the quarters so that we can spawn more units. Each quarter, as mentioned, can only spawn 2 more units. But even, like, now we're 20 minutes into the video, you can see there's some decent stuff going on. If you have idle units, you put them up here, and you have research be done. We've really got to get this extraction done as quickly as possible. Otherwise, we could have, I guess, theoretically put ourselves in a position where we would just lose this map, I guess, because we could hit a lose condition by running out of materials without being able to build this extractor, and hopefully we don't find ourselves in that position. In fact, I should probably smarten up and build like another corridor out here and get another extractor up basically as soon as possible. We'll see if maybe that works. Yeah, sure. That'll be fine as well. But I really want, again, you're pulled in so many different ways as you're playing this. You want to build gardens, and if you build a garden, you have to build a kitchen. What's the point of having so much food if you don't have more quarters to put the food in, right? Or you don't have more construction going on to use the food for, because kitchens and quarters and weapons rooms and gardens require food to build. And a lot of my resources just got depleted right there, actually. And, you know, you constantly want to build quarters because as you... Oh, we need to put people on food service. Everyone else can go on defense, though. As you build, yes, you should just send everyone here, basically. As you build up, that doesn't change. You're just constantly having to deal with multiple priorities. Hopefully, these units can actually... This guy is going to be a bit of a straggler. I don't think he's going to make it to his defense post. Or maybe he is. Oh, you know what? I remember now, because I'm not actually, yeah, that was only two enemies that time, but I didn't actually have, like, full power to defense. Anyway, so why don't we put you all in there, and then we'll put you guys back on research. And we'll probably end this video once I finish researching one monolith here. This is one of the videos, and this happens from time to time, where I'm kind of saying to you, like, take my word for it. And I understand that makes a lot of people a little bit uncomfortable, but if you like what you see, I don't see any reason to think that this will not be worth $8. I don't think this is going to be your standard, like, mobile to PC port, where you're going to play it for like 15 minutes while you're pooping or something like that. It's not going to be like that. Plus, you should just use the phone version. Are you taking your laptop in every time you go to the bathroom? That's like super unsanitary, man. But I guess it's not that much less unsanitary than using your phone necessarily. But that was a distracting topic for me to get on. But anyway, what I was going to say is that I think this is definitely the kind of puzzle game that I could see people putting 8 to 12 hours in. I don't know how much depth there is beyond this. There are some other modes. There's a plus mode and a Zen mode. Whenever it comes to games like this, I typically just stick to the vanilla stuff. I'm assuming the Zen mode either has no aggressive waves or it has a longer distance between waves, so you can just focus more on the building aspect. As I see it right now, you know, different strokes for different folks, but the waves come few and far between enough, at least at the start of the game from what I've played so far, that I don't necessarily see the appeal for myself personally in a Zen mode, but I do like the pace at which the normal mode works, although I do wish that for the first few, the first few waves, basically, because we're approaching like wave 6 or 7 here or something now, I do wish for that the first few waves we could use a fast forward button. I think that would be something that would benefit the game for people who prefer to play at a faster pace if they've already done the level a couple of times. We really need to get this extractor up. What is being constructed right now? Okay. Again, this is where the other thing that's going to be either a positive or a negative, depending on your perspective, is the lack of direct control over your units. What this means is no micromanagement, but it does also mean like, oh, I want to prioritize this extractor. Well, too bad. The units have minds of their own. I, as well, am of two minds of it. I can understand some people being frustrated by it. I don't really mind it so much, but there are times when I'm like, oh my god, if you would just build the extractor now, that would stop putting us behind the eight ball so much, and we could really, you know, get out of our own kind of lull here as soon as possible. But it's also just a mechanic of how the game works, so, you know, that's for better or worse. I don't necessarily, for me, I'm kind of mixed on it, let's put it that way. So the quarter is going to be up here, which actually means I should put one unit on food service, but pretty soon we're going to move all units to defense again. But you can see how, like, as waves go on, it kind of gets exponentially more complex and interesting as well. We might actually be lucky enough to finish our research before the next wave comes, and we'll see what kind of perk we get here. Because I don't know if it happens, like, if the first monolith you research is always units move faster, or if it's, you know, the monoliths actually have some kind of set value or set attribute that they improve or give you. Oh man, come on, just research faster, please. I know you can do it. I don't really care how this video goes or what happens after this video, so just finish. Okay, we should put many units on defense now. Oh, there we go. Extractors are more efficient. Okay, well, that'll be great if I can ever get this extractor up. Idle units should go to defense, please. Now, are we going to get lucky enough? No, lots of our units are actually going to get zapped. Make it to the defense room! We killed one. We might get lucky here. We might be able to kill this one before he kills me. Okay, we did! Alright, and we didn't lose any units, did we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright! Well, that's going to do it for my Let's Look at a Reamed Capsule. It's an unusual game, but it is, it's not your traditional puzzler for sure, despite the way it might look in screenshots. It's very much a strategy game, kind of like a more zen-like, minimalistic base builder, a 4X game, like a Civ, or, you know, to some extent, although this comparison doesn't hold very well, like a Crusader Kings or a Europa Universalis. $8, $7.20 for its opening week sale. I think it's pretty cool. If you want to pick it up, there will be a link in the video description below, and you can pick it up on Steam. And of course, as always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more first impressions like this in the future. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.